Hello and welcome to another week of Ten's Weird News. I'm Tess Walcott, keeping you up to date with all things weird and wonderful from right around the world. And I'd love to hear your feedback too, especially if you've got some strange story ideas closer to home. You can get in touch by using our hashtag #10WeirdNews. I'm looking forward to hearing your ideas. They say pigs can't fly. Well, the same doesn't apply to cats. Meet Bob Bob. This 14-month-old feline is quite the airport security sleuth. His owner flew from Ohio to Florida without realizing she had packed more than just her toiletries.
My daughter said my face, just she knew something was wrong because I thought we had a dead cat in the suitcase.
Not happy being left at home, Bob Bob eluded several airport screeners, although this guy did think he saw the bag move.
I'm thinking, guys, wait a minute, this is amazing. I'm like, guess my highest was in playing chicks.
Not sure if he still has a job. Staying in the US and get ready for the funniest baby face you've ever seen. An overzealous reporter was not much of a hit with this teeny tiny viewer.
E equals MC squared. Get the camera off my face. I'll take this cantaloupe.
Oh no! Oh Dan, don't make him cry. And his terrible Wiggles rendition didn't seem to fix things either. Now, here's a guy who can give Arnie a run for his money. Meet Mustafov Ismail, also known as the man with the world's largest biceps.
I have the power, like, to lift a lot.
He works hard at it too, spending hours in the gym every day, bench pressing 225 kgs. Each bicep measures around 78 centimeters. If you put that in perspective, that's much bigger than a supermodel's waist. On the subject of beauties, get ready for the fishiest pageant you've ever seen. 3,000 glammed-up Nemos went head-to-head in China for the title of World Goldfish Queen. Like any high-stakes pageant, competitors are judged on poise, body shape, and a swimming technique. And it would appear bigger is certainly better, with this 1.75 kg hopeful taking home the crown. Tess Walcock, 10 News.